I really appreciate this question because this is the work that I do every day. I've devoted my life for the last 4 years, and I plan to devote the rest of my life to working to develop real solutions to climate change. We can talk all we want about environmental degradation, but the fact is, this entire district will be underwater when half of the world's ice caps melt, and we're on pace for all of them to melt. That's the bottom line. So it's absolutely shameful that Jeff Van Drew wants to take New Jersey out of the regional cap and trade consortium. This is, he says it's bad for business. Well, there won't be any businesses in South Jersey. There will not be a South Jersey in a couple hundred years if we continue going down this path. As I mentioned earlier, I got involved in South Jersey before I moved here, working with Occupy Sandy, working on Sandy recovery. And I worked in some of the poorest communities across New Jersey, places that were not getting any attention from FEMA, from the Red Cross, places like the trailer parks on the back bays of behind Wildwood, as far north as Bergen County, places like Moonaki, where there were manufactured housing communities where hundreds of people lived that were just completely flooded. And I realized through the course of that work that climate change is a social justice issue. I've heard that before, but I realized it in a way that that you can't unless you see it. That people who are already struggling are going to deal with the effects of the climate crisis first and worst. And if we don't do something to stand up for them, then that's really criminal. It's a crime and shame. So I started the Experimental Farm Network, the nonprofit that I run, because I realized that agriculture is such a huge problem. I've always had a passion for plants, for farming, and I realized if we don't get people working on these things, like perennial wheat, that people have been working on, plugging away at for a century, but there's never any institutional heft behind it. The corporations, Monsanto, they have no interest in perennial crops because their business model involves selling seeds to farmers every year and the chemicals that go along with those genetically modified seeds. They're things like Roundup. The government has been colluding with these companies for decades, and we need to stop that. They're making us sick, it's causing cancer, it's causing birth defects, they may have a role in autism and allergies, and yet the government still insists that these things are safe. There's a lawsuit in California. I urge all of you to take a look at that. The judge mandated that internal documents be released, and they prove that there has been conspiracy to keep this from the public between the FDA and companies like Monsanto. It would have been big news back in October, but right now Donald Trump sucks all the energy out of the news, and everything is about him. So we need to focus on these issues. We need people who not only care about these issues, but who know intimately how to solve it. And climate change, it's the pivotal issue of our generation. If we don't do something about this, we're not going to have a future. The planet as we recognize it will not exist. And this district, you'll only be able to explore it as a scuba diver. That's the bottom line.